And yep, now that's happening. That's now a thing. That is
It is
happening.
a thing.
We're doing a thing, everybody.
And
my
very
phone is now
excited.
on Do Not Disturb. And I'm also going to retweet.
And I'm going to briefly switch to this because I forgot I need to do one more thing. And I don't want people to have to look at all my windows while I work on it. Because I need to open up the chat so I can see that.
All right. And I'm starting Alpha Geek.
Seeing the chat's important. Have to look at all my windows
Uh-oh.
While... And there's going to be an echo because I forgot to turn the audio off.
Echo.
And I need to remember to get out of Slack so that when everybody starts pinging me, that doesn't go off. Learned my lesson last time. All right, I think I've done all the things that I'm supposed to do.
Yay.
All of
So Jocelyn, I think that you were actually on the first episode that we had with no show notes. We've gotten a little better with it.
Good. I couldn't remember if I actually did one with no show notes or not, but I think you're right.
Yeah.
It's the very first time.
So yeah, it's going to be fun. I have an idea of kind of maybe something to talk about, but we'll see what happens.
Who knows? That's the exciting thing.
Yes. You never know. Do-do-do.
Super stoked.
And chat room, let me know if there's any audio or weirdness. Hopefully... The stuttering that we had last week is fixed. I lowered the...
And hopefully the shadow people didn't follow me to my new house.
I'm sure they didn't.
No.
They attached to the old house. That's just a shadow people fact.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, good.
You just have
good.
New shadow people in this one.
Oh.
See, Damn he's it. The one being mean now at this
That's
point.
That's true.
Ben
no,
is officially being the mean one. Although...
Here's the thing. I mean, they're new people that, you know, bake them a cake or something and welcome them to your life now. And it's fine. You don't have to worry about it.
After...
I don't know. They were pretty scary. I had some nightmares. And then there was that whole dog, not a dog story. And at least I don't live alone anymore.
Yeah, but then, see, here's the thing that I'm excited about. Scott got addicted to that, like, putting faces on top of other thing faces.
Oh, my
oh God.
That is the thing of nightmares.
It's and terrifying.
So now is forgiven because I'm now not the person haunting Jocelyn anymore.
Exactly. Oh, God, that is the worst trend of ever. Ever.
But yeah. I think he hit his peak with the dog thing. And, like, I don't think it can get any better now, so.
I hope he just gives it up. I hope that's it.
Well, knowing him, it'll probably pop up again in another week or two.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, man. Yeah, the first one I saw, it's absolutely terrifying. Like, little...
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I just... Weird. It's like Benjamin Button taken to the extreme in a very wrong way.
You know what it's like for me? You know those like the faces where they have the miles where the eyes are supposed to be?
Oh yeah.
And you're just like, you know, that probably shouldn't freak me out because it's just a mouth. But it's so wrong that it just terrifies me. Like, that's not supposed to go there.
No, it's incredibly unsettling.
Exactly, it's unsettling.
Yeah, you don't want one of those winking or blinking at you.
No,
but
no.
You don't want it open either. So either way, it's a lose-lose.
What do you even do with that?
Yeah,
eat it.
Gross.
It's probably like the perfect size for like a mozzarella stick or something. Just shove that in there and run.
Oh, but then you have mozzarella sticks in your eyes.
Ugh. Hey, you know what I did recently? I had mozzarella sticks from McDonald's. Let
what?
Me tell you, it might be better to just put those in your eyes rather than eat them.
They have mozzarella sticks at McDonald's?
Yeah, they do. It's bad.
Ugh.
It's real bad. It's a nightmare.
I heard.
It feels like Ronald McDonald was explained what a mozzarella stick was and just went, I don't know. This, I guess.
Close enough. Just breaded cheese, right? How hard could it be?
Yeah.
But then we put it in oil and deep fry it.
It's got chicken in it, right? No, Ronald. No, it doesn't.
Does it have burgers or fish?
Why are we letting the clown cook?
I wonder if anyone's ever actually asked that. Like, wait, how did the clown become in charge of the kitchen?
Who put the clown in charge of this company? He's just leaning back.
Wouldn't you like to know?
And the funny thing is, the Hamburglar actually isn't stealing stuff because he wants it. He's stealing it to, like, have proof that it's, like, murdered kids or something.
He's a vigilante trying to stop.
He's the Batman of McDonald's.
He's trying to save us.
Big Macs are people. They're people.
Oh, man.
The Hamburglar tried to warn us about the pink goo. We didn't listen. We didn't listen.
Oh. And then Ronald has just his ultimate weapon, the grimace.
No, not the grimace.
So this is just what the show is now?
Yeah.
Yeah, pretty much.
There's no show notes, so we just talk about McDonald's.
Yeah.
You know, but then again, we were doing that before, even when we had show notes. So.
Yeah, true. That's true. Mozzarella sticks, though. That's just...
Yeah, don't do it. It's a trap.
What else are they going to have? Potato skins?
I don't know. Do it. They would have to have potatoes to have potato skins.
True. Although, don't you bash those fries. Those fries are amazing.
Would you say they're McMazing?
Don't. What are you doing? Why would you
I would say,
that?
They are amazing, like I did.
Why would
They've
you
got a hold
go
on
there?
Me, John. They got a hold on me.
Oh my god, my camera's totally doing the thing again. It never does that.
Yeah, the green weirdness.
Yeah.
I did notice it.
Ah, oh, god damn.
Jocelyn, the shadow people found
you. Yeah, they found me. They were totally fine Yeah.
Oh, I like your mic. That's a good brand.
Thanks. I'm trying to get... everything's all messed up.
So you said I like your mic. I was like, man, she's got one of those cool chairs. What kind of chair is that everybody seems to have?
DX yeah. or something?
I need
it's
one
a
of
DX
those.
DX Racer. I got one, I guess in like May of this past year, but I had to sell it when I moved. So this is actually Matt's chair. He loaned it to me until I can get enough donations to get a new chair.
I need a new chair so bad. Mine is.
It's so comfy. Oh my god.
Mine is shocking looking. Mine looks horrible. It is falling apart in ways that are unnatural. So I don't know if I should I don't know if I should even tell this story.
Yeah, tell the story.
So the fabric on the chair has now like started to come off, but when it first started to do it, like, it's a blue pad on the chair, but it turns out the like stuffing or whatever inside is like brown. And like, I had a legitimate moment where I stood up and looked down at my chair and I was like, is there poo on my chair?
I just picture you standing up saying, I shit my chair. I shit my chair.
How did I not feel that?
So I was like staring at it and I'm trying to figure out what it is. Because it was at that stage where the fabric wasn't like all gone. It was just faded through to where you could kind of see through it. So it looked like it was all, you know, I guess mushed in the chair. And I'm like staring.
Like poop would be.
Yes, like poop would be. And I'm staring at it and I'm like, well, there's really only one way to find out. I mean, I had
you
to know.
Put your face in it,
I had
you?
To know. No, oh. You didn't go right for the face. That's the nuclear option. I like reached in slowly and was like, well, I can always wash my hands if this goes bad. And I gave it a little scratch. And then I was like, oh, that just feels like the padding on the chair. That's fine. But I did sniff my finger because I needed to confirm.
Oh, the old finger sniff test.
It passed. We're fine. Everything's fine.
Yeah, we're good. We're good, guys.
No poop here.
We're good. It wasn't poop. It wasn't poop. Good news, everybody. It wasn't poop.
Oh,
okay.
My God.
Well, on that note, I think it's about time to start the show. What do you
think?
We should
probably
start the show.
All right. Let's see. Then, in that case, Jocelyn, whenever you are ready, feel free to kick us off. And remember, brand new year, we're not going to interrupt you. everything's going to be cool. You're in a new house, new year, no show notes.
New beginnings. New beginning.
Mm-hmm. Okay. This is Jocelyn from the Gamers Inn and the
This episode of Azeroth Roundtable is brought to you by SlashLoot.com, where you can buy the official Azeroth Roundtable t-shirt. At SlashLoot.com, there's no RNG. You're guaranteed to get some loot. It's also brought to you by the official Azeroth Roundtable keychain and pendant, available at geekasylum.etsy.com. Check it out for all your Murloc with a microphone needs.
I totally powered right through you anyway, so you just have to use that one.
Welcome to Azeroth Roundtable, episode 146. My name is Ben Bumhoffer, and with me is John. How's it going, John?
Hi, Ben. Happy to be here. Intro seemed a little weird.
Yes,
I don't know why
did.
Jocelyn wanted to talk over our opening promo. I guess she's just not familiar with the new format of the show, but...
Wow. Wow. It's good to be back, guys. Thanks for having me. Changing the rules all over the place.
Wow. I want to point out, yet again, was not me. Just leaving that there.
That was a double whammy. That was one on Jocelyn. That was one on the chat room. They were saying I was getting too predictable with the shirt. So we had to pull out something new.
Yeah. Yes, we did. Jocelyn, thank you so much for joining us on our first real episode of 2016.
Why, did you do a fake one last week or something?
Thank you for being our first guest of 2016.
You are welcome. Thank you for having me. It's always a blast coming on here. I have no other WoW outlets, so... Azeroth Roundtable's my happy place.
Yay. Well, we always enjoy having you on. But one other thing that we really enjoy is when you show up to raid.
Yay.
It's so cool having you on the raid team now.
Yeah, it's super intense for me, I've got to say. I am not a PvE-er. I'm not a raider. I don't keep up on, like, you know, how... I didn't even know, like, I went to raid last night, and I didn't even know how to get Valor. I'm like, I'm... 710 geared from Ashran, yay! Like, please don't kick me out. My gear doesn't upgrade.
Well, okay, to be fair, John, do you know how to get Valor?
Kill people?
No. Close, though.
Oh, okay. I've been doing it wrong.
That's why you haven't gotten any.
But yeah, so I just, like, I don't know. I feel like such a noob, so... We go into raid, and at least this time, I had my potions and my flask, and I had, like, 60 savage feasts in case we just wiped a lot. I was like, at least I can contribute food. It's like you come to a party, you have to have something to bring for everyone.
It's like, food. If you get invited to a potluck, but you don't know the people super well, you're like, they'll accept me because I have food.
Exactly.
That's how it goes.
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, every time we had, like, a wipe or a death, I was like, oh, place is feast. I know this.
Okay, Joss, so the boss strat on this, place a feast.
Yeah.
Okay, we're
nailed
good.
It.
And then we will fight it, and we want you to also do damage. But thanks for the feast.
So, yeah, it's because, like, so the first week that I was there, I watched all the videos, and I was super prepped for Iskar and the big robot dude after that, and then
Soccer,
another dude.
Well, you're already ahead of Civ, so good job.
I was super ready for those three, and then we started at the bottom, and then so I didn't know any of those fights, because I was like, I watched what was posted in the forums. Crap. So then they had to go through all the strats, and they're like, okay, here's the rundown, and like, 30 seconds, and this is Ben being amazing, telling me what to do, and he's just like, okay, you need to know this and this and this, and move here, and when this is cast, you go this and this and this and this, and these are all the names of all the spells you need to watch for, go! I'm like, okay!
Yeah, John, the thing is the first week that she was with us, I started rowing an explanation.
Oh no, Ben, don't ever row an explanation.
But that's the thing is, I kind of had to, because it was Puddles. You know, the guy with the three puddles, I forget his name, who cares?
We call him Puddles, it's fine.
Yeah. Because there's three puddles.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, when this happens, this, and everything. So I had to. And then Ro called me out on it.
It's like, Ben, it was hilarious.
You're starting to row this. I'm like, I am. Go ahead. And then he continued and finished about the same amount of explanation that I would have used.
So. All right. Well, I have not gotten to raid with Jocelyn yet, so I have some follow-up questions just to make sure that she's doing the team proper. And that, you know, in my absence, things are still going as expected. Are you watching football while you play?
No, that's the thing. Like, there are people in there that have adult beverages. There are people that are watching things on other monitors. They're clicking links and talking about stuff that's happening on Twitter. And I'm like, guys, it's great time. What are you doing? Like, how can you do this? I'm just like, I need to move here, and then I need to do this, and then nobody talk to me, please. I can't even handle push to talk right now.
Has Akuzad yelled at you?
No.
Okay. He wasn't there either time.
Oh, yeah, okay. He hasn't been there. Okay.
Well, wait, that's coming.
Well, see, but I don't know, because I hear that Hunts gets pretty competitive too, and so he died in one of the fights, and I didn't die until, like, the whole raid wiped.
I mean, but that makes you better than Hunt.
Died and I didn't die.
Yeah,
and I
was that's like, just yes! math. That's just Hunter math.
So I figure I'm good.
All right.
Well,
good.
I'm totally not going to call you out on the time that you were standing in fire and didn't move until, like, halfway through. I noticed.
Wow, Ben. But oh, I totally to just am not throw our that. Guest under the bus.
I was like, I don't even remember that happening.
That's because I kept you alive.
Yeah, you did. Yep. Unless it was, there was like a time where there was like green fiery stuff on the ground and I couldn't get around it. I tried to run around it, but it went all the way to the wall. And I was like, I have to go through this. Like, literally don't have a choice.
That's what it was. I was just.
Oh, okay. I'm just going to be way out of position. They're telling me to stack, and I have to stack.
Yeah, John, I don't think you've seen the fight at all. It's the Iskar fight. And she was, like, seriously, like, in an island oasis of, like, fire all around her. Nowhere to go. And we're all stacked up. I looked over there. I'm like, she's coming through the fire.
Well, I was like, I'm pretty sure that if I stand here all by myself, I just die, because isn't the whole idea that it like spreads damage across the people that are stacked in the place? Mm-hmm. So I'm like, if I don't have anybody stacked with me, I'm just gonna get one shot.
Pretty much.
So I thought I made a good raid choice.
Well, it sounds like you're happy to be raiding with the team. Are you into the raiding?
It's a different experience, but it was a lot of fun. Like, once I started to get the hang of it, once we wiped once or twice on each boss, and I was like, oh, now I get it. Okay.
Yeah, and the thing is a lot of raiding takes a lot of different practice, especially when you're learning different progression fights. Because the first night you're with us, we just breezed through everything because we've done those so many times. Yeah. But last night, the big difference is that we're on, you know, not as familiar bosses. I mean, we got two of them down that were the last two that we were working on. And Sunday, there's a good chance that we're going to be doing brand new boss that we fought, I think, once.
Oh, good.
So you're totally in it with us at that point, because, you know, that's when everybody's going to be yelling at each other to move and stuff like that.
Okay, good.
So perfect.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like I'm excited to learn, and it's a totally different way of playing because I'm used to every fight being different, and as long as I know my rotation and I don't do anything really stupid, I can pretty much make my way through PvP and it's not a big deal. Sometimes I get caught out by a rogue or something, and that just happens.
Yeah, no rogues.
Yeah, it's just damn rogues. But you know, like, in general, like, PvP is fairly straightforward yet different every time, because your team comp is different every time, both who you're fighting and who you're fighting with. As soon as you go into PvE, there's this like huge knowledge base of stuff that you have to know about each fight, like where you have to stand, what you have to target. And I even struggle with that, because in PvP it's just you kill the healer, then you kill the DPS, then you kill the tank, and it's a very simple order. You just have to know what specs and what classes are the healers and all that kind of stuff. But even then, there's an add-on for it. It's called Healers Have to Die, and it puts a big like you know, like plus sign above them, and mm-hmm. you just kill the plus sign, and it's pretty easy. But like, even just like targeting in raids for me is so hard. I'm like, there's got to be an easier way. But I'm just like trying to like switch between things, and then I'm always the one who's doing the switching because I'm DPS. So it's like, okay, this thing has to die, and then this thing has to die, and I'm like, oh my god, so much pressure. Like, you have to know where to stand, and even then, I'm playing a hunter, so I am ranged. I can move around a lot, and I have really good vision of everything. But man, oh man, like, keeping track of your movement, keeping track of what's going on in the fight, and then what's upcoming, and when to interrupt, and when to pop your cooldowns, which is the thing that I learned. So, yeah, I don't know. It's just, it's so intense, and I feel like I'm juggling so many things, and then I'm like, oh my god, and I have to DPS. I should be pushing buttons right now. Oh man, I feel like my DPS just tanked last night because I was like trying to keep track of where I was supposed to go and what I was supposed to target, and I'd be like, okay, I'm standing in the right spot and I'm targeting the right thing. Wait a minute. Now's when the fighting starts.
Wait, there's buttons to press at the same time.
So, yeah, man, oh man, it's like way intimidating just because there's that huge knowledge base that I don't have, and I don't have the experience that you guys have, whereas like you've been raiding through expansion after expansion after expansion, so you're used to, you know, learning curves and what it's supposed to be like. And for me, every time my GTFO goes off being like, meh, 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 I'm like, oh my god, I'm gonna wipe the raid. What am I standing in right now? So it's just like, because you guys are such an established raid team. Like, when I was raiding before, I was running my own raid team. We were doing like, we were end of expansion geared for beginning of expansion content. So it was like we were overpowered and, you know, just kind of trying to learn Pandaria stuff. And it fell apart as soon as we got to Draenor because, like, we couldn't beat, like, the first boss of the raid at all. So we were just like, well, this is dumb and we're bad. So everyone just go do your own thing. Okay, cool. Bye. So but you guys, like, you've been at it for so long. So it's just, it's this whole new world for me.
Let me ask you.
The good news is, just really quick, John, I actually just looked at the stats from the raid last night, and you did pretty good.
Yay!
Look at that.
Sorry, you're not Hunts the Wind yet, but you did pretty good.
Yeah, but he died.
No one but Hunts is, yeah, well, he dies, yeah.
So, you know what?
To be fair, I died a lot, too. There was just that one time. Yeah.
So, yeah. Did good.
But let me ask you. So you are, if I understand correctly, you're trying to learn a little bit more Heroes of the Storm, but you are also a big fan of Smite.
Yes.
Which is harder to learn, in your opinion? Because I always hear these people who play WoW. These people, I'm one of them. But I always hear these people who play WoW.
These WoW people.
These WoW players, whoever they are. But, you know, you hear these MMO players and they're like, oh man, I just can't get into HOTS or Dota or League. It's just too complicated. And I think, well, yeah, but you raid. Like, raiding's pretty complicated, right? Like, now that you're kind of going through that process, which do you think is more challenging? And do you think that maybe that challenge is an intimidation factor going across?
It is 100% an intimidation factor. I think there's just kind of this mental block that some people have, and I had for a really long time, just like preventing them from going into some kind of a multiplayer competitive environment, whether that's WoW PvP, whether that's a MOBA, whether, you know, anything, even some people for it's like Rocket League, you know, it just, yeah. It doesn't matter what it is. As soon as your opponent is not a computer, for some people, it's just like, well, I don't even want to try because I know I'm going to be bad. And so there's kind of that going into it, that kind of hurdle you have to get over, which is what happened to me in PvP and WoW, because I love competitive things. I don't know if you guys have noticed. I'm like wicked competitive. So going into WoW PvP, I was just like, oh man, I'm going to be so bad. Everyone else has been playing for like 8 years. And then they brought Ashran out, and I was just like, well, I'm one of like 100 people. Even if I'm bad, they're probably not going to notice because I'm not AFK in the base. So right. I'll get those points at least. So, you know, you just have to kind of find that one thing to put yourself over that hurdle. And then it kind of opens up this whole realm of gaming where, you know, you can go in and try Heroes. You can go in and try Smite. And I don't really know about League and Dota because I didn't find those communities very inviting. But wherever your friends are playing, like, it makes it a whole lot easier for you to jump into it. And even then, I still find Heroes really intimidating because I love Smite. And I got really into Smite when I couldn't get into Heroes. And then I try Heroes, and I'm like, I should be good at this, but I just can't wrap my head around it. And I finally figured it out like a week ago. It's because there's a learning curve of Heroes. Mm-hmm. There's a learning curve of, like, actual, like, talents. And there's a learning curve of the whole objective of the map. So you've got, right, like, three major things that you have to learn of, like, how your character plays, what skills you should pick to make your character play the way that fits your play style, and then what you have to do on each map, which changes every time. So if you're just queuing into random stuff with random people, like, man, is that hard to learn and hard to coordinate and hard to get good at, because, like, everyone else is in the same boat as you going, like, well, do we mercs? Do we lanes? Do we objectives? Do we, what even is the objective?
God, why does this pirate try to yelling run into at
the
me?
Other... Well, there's the pirate yelling at you. There's, like, the one where you can't even go into the base. They're just like, oh, nuked. Oh, you crossed the line, nuked. So, you know, like, it's not even consistent in that, like, there's three lanes. There's maps with two lanes. So, you know, it really quickly snowballs into this huge knowledge base that you have to have. Plus, on top of that, then it's a PvP experience as well. So, man, yeah, no, Heroes is intimidating, and I totally get that because I haven't played Heroes a lot at all for those specific reasons. But, man, those objectives make it really tough to learn.
Well, I'll tell you one quick Heroes tip, and then we'll go back to WoW. But I think you'll like this. Okay. So that map where you can't go into the enemy's base because you get nuked.
Yep.
Jocelyn, I think you will appreciate this because it is mean and it will make you laugh, and I know that you occasionally get a little mean streak in you when you're playing competitively.
No, if you
pick a hero that can knock a player back or move their position, you can knock the enemy team into that firing squad in front of your base and watch them get immediately nuked down by your cannons. And it is the most rewarding thing in the world if you can do it.
But I think, like, this is the thing that, okay, so if I pick a hero, then I want to pick a hero that has a knockback, but then I queue into quick match and I have no idea what map I'm going to get into. So, like, there's that kind of disconnect too, because, like, if you queue into Smite Conquest, you're going to get the Smite Conquest map. Like, whatever game mode you choose, there's the map.
The map.
And that's how you play, and that's where you play, and that's it. Well, so with Heroes, you can't choose your hero based on your map, so you might be at a huge disadvantage if you just queue into the wrong map randomly.
Right.
Yeah.
It kind of requires you to get good at a hero, and then hopefully you get the right map. Or once you get to ranked, then you at least get to see the map beforehand.
Oh, yeah, that's true, because everything I've been playing is quick match, because I'm only level 23, I think.
So it'll happen, but
yeah, but
you'll do it one day and you'll be stoked.
One of the big things about Heroes that I like more than, like, say MAP or Dota or League is the fact that there is the variety in there, much like in raiding. Every single, like, encounter that you have is something entirely different. But kind of like John was saying, though, the learning curve on that is very difficult because everything is so different. I mean, even just from expansion to expansion, you go from Burning Crusade, there's a lot of fights where it's like, stand here and kill shit. Then there's another fight where you stand here and then move once and then kill everything. And then this one, you need to kill it really fast. Whereas now you have so much stuff flying and you know, just falling from the ceiling, and there's fire everywhere. And
there is so much fire. Like, I couldn't get over it. It's like every single fight is like, don't stand in the fire he spews. Don't stand in the fire that comes behind him. Don't stand in the fire laser. Okay, fire bad. Got it.
There's a lot of fire in raiding.
Oh, yeah. Man. like actual literal on the ground, like green fire.
Mm-hmm. Well, the thing is, Blizzard, you know, they gave it to Warlocks and it's a really cool asset and they wanted to play with it too. So they just made an entire raid where everything is fire.
Makes sense.
Yeah,
totally makes sense.
But I do agree. I think like raiding is definitely a more complex thing. I mean, I feel like it, your rotation changes every expansion, it feels like, or at least typically it will, you know, the enchants, the potions, making sure you have the right gear, making sure you've got your seals or whatever small mammal that you need to collect next time, you know, just making sure you're set across the board, then knowing the fights and they're all different, and then knowing what your rotation needs to be in that, potting during it, activating your cooldowns, activating your legendary ring in this case. Like, there's so many things to keep track of. It's definitely more complex, but I do think you're right. It's not as intimidating because the raid bosses don't mock you and troll you while you're fighting them like a real player.
Well, not only that, is like, because they're so repeatable, because they do the same thing every single time, it's like they have to be very, very challenging and very complicated, or they'd get stupid easy really quickly. You know, like PvP is different every time because you're facing another person. So that person on the other end of it is going to make different decisions every time. I can't go into a fight against a Ret Pally and be like, OK, I know exactly how this is going to go. And I have to push like A, B, C, D at second 1, 3, right, 8 and 10.
Yeah.
You know, like, it's different every single time. So, I mean, they have to make PvE more challenging and they have to make things stronger and difficult. Otherwise, people would just be like, well, we finished this raid in a day and that's it. Like, you know, end of expansion, end of story. So this way, at least it's challenging. You have to go back in week after week. You know, it takes a while for people to actually feel like they can farm a boss. So I think, yeah, that's the reason why, right? Like, they're challenging in different ways.
Yeah. So, and one of the big differences too is, you know, PvP, especially if you queue, generally you're queuing solo. I mean, it's not exactly the same as like queuing for LFR or anything, but it is, because you just don't know who you're going to end up with.
Whereas, that is like my horror place, LFR. Not only is it PvE raiding, but it's with like 25 random people. Just, I'm going to go jump in front of a train instead, okay? I will never LFR. I can't do it.
Well, the good news is that there is a boss that involves trains in Black Rock Foundry, so you could do that.
Oh, fun! I actually, Grimrail Depot was like one of the only dungeons that I actually ran in this expansion, and it was so much fun.
I know, I actually like that one too, when I'm not killing anyway.
I did it so early, I was at the stage where nobody knew what to do in that fight.
I know, I did it like the first 2 or 3 days the expansion was out. I can't even remember.
And it was so great because no one knew. We were just like hiding behind boxes like, I don't know, he's got a gun. What do you want to do? I don't know, he's shooting at us. We're just going to hide back here, I guess. Why don't you go out there and do something? Why don't you go out there and do something?
Guys, I can loot that body.
Don't touch it. Don't touch anything. Just hide behind these boxes. The boxes are safe. And then the next thing you know, you're on fire. So it's interesting. But Jocelyn, I did have one question I really wanted to ask you as it pertains to Legion coming out. You are now entering the wonderful world of raiding, but prior to that, you were in the competitive world of PvP. You are now about to face Legion, where they are going to have PvP unique talents and a whole leveling system unique to PvP. Is that exciting? Is that now daunting when you look at it as a, you know, potentially raider going into the next expansion as well? Or do you think that's going to pull you right back in and get you excited about it again?
Can I please have it tomorrow? I need to prestige all the things. I can't wait. I hate that there are two different currencies right now, and so two different tiers of gear. So you've got your honor and your conquest. Your conquest is better. And the difference between like a 710 piece of conquest gear and a 700 piece of honor gear is pretty much like 10% power. Basically, it's like 1% power per item level. So if you've got somebody fully conquest geared and someone who's fully honor geared, they're like just 10% better off the bat. So it's just, it's crazy, stupid, ridiculous differences based on just a, strictly a currency. And conquest, now that there's Ashran, you can go in and get conquest in Ashran, which makes it a little bit more accessible. But previous to that, it was like raided battlegrounds and arenas. And those are ridiculously intimidating. Arenas are just like 2v2, 3v3, and 5v5, I think. And they're really, really quick, but really intimidating because there's like just like you and one other person and so ragey. And then And then raided battlegrounds, like I don't mind queuing into regular battlegrounds. I find those fun. But actually, they're my favorite part of Warcraft is just regular, normal battlegrounds. Mm-hmm. But raided battlegrounds, man, people, again, so ragey, so angry. If you don't know exactly what to do, and if you aren't on point, and if you aren't already fully conquest geared, just get out. Like, just, they don't want anything to do with you. So it makes it really, really difficult to have a cohesive team. But yeah, I love battlegrounds. I love Ashran. And to be able to basically do whatever I want, because when Ashran was actually fun, a few patches ago, mm-hmm. I mean, I was in there for like 12 hours a day. Like, pretty much I would come home from work, I would Ashran for like however many hours I had between work and podcasting, and then I'd Ashran some more, and then my whole entire weekends were just Ashran. I just loved it. I was just in there, I was just messing up people. It was super fun. And then they nerfed it and changed it, and we've talked about that on this show mm-hmm. before, so I won't go into everything that they did, but
I don't think you used the Ashran as a verb before, which I think is pretty great, and I think we should all adopt that.
Absolutely.
I was busy Ashranning. Sorry, everybody. Sorry.
Exactly.
What was she doing?
She's not important.
Does she need to go to a doctor?
She's got a case of the Ashrans.
Timmy, what are you doing up there? You better not be Ashranning.
I'm not, Mom. Leave me alone.
Are you Ashranning in there?
No.
Okay.
Okay. Oh, man. She's gone with Ashran.
Yeah, so I'm really looking forward to basically whatever PvP activity it is that I want to do in Legion, whether I want to get crazy and do some arenas or if I want to do just some more laid-back battlegrounds or if they have some other world-type PvP area. I don't really know what they're going to do with Ashran or what their plans are for having any kind of world PvP, but I'm sure there will be something. But whatever I decide to do, as long as I do it enough and I'm enjoying it, I'm going to be earning like PvP XP, whatever they're going to call that. Mm-hmm. And I'll be able to work towards talents and basically I'll be on the same scale. I might not prestige as quickly. I might not hit max level as quickly as someone who wants to do just arenas, because I'm sure they're going to weight it so that you earn more honor, XP, whatever, mm-hmm. For, you know, the traditionally more challenging PvP activities, which you should. But the thing is, they're not going to gate it the way that it currently is. So I can't wait. Like, I want it now. And every single time there's any kind of like big Legion announcement, it's like normally just like, we're going to talk all the PvE things. And like, it took forever even to get an answer if like Honor and Conquest were still going to be currencies. They were just like, we have a new PvP system. Don't ask us any questions. Say bye.
Leave us alone. We talked about it. We'll see you in a year.
Yeah, exactly. And like, I mean, still the only information that we really have is like data mined out of patches. It's not like, here's Blizzard talking PvP. So that worries me a little because I don't want it to feel like pushed aside. Like, I hope that, I love that they had Ashran, that Ashran was a thing, and that they tried to at least put what I felt was as much effort into PvP. Whether they were successful or not is a whole other conversation for probably another night. But just the fact that they tried to put that in there, and there were quests and there were objectives and there was like all this other, like it was a rich area in and of itself. So the fact that they did that, I think, was really, really good. And I hope they do the same thing, but I'm a little bit worried because we haven't heard anything about anything PvP since we're going to have prestige. There will be mounts. Yay.
You will unlock a golden AK-47 if you prestige.
I really just want my portrait to be like, this bitch is a badass.
Okay, well, you know, as we were talking, I kind of had an idea on how I think Ashran would be better
Okay, you're going to improve the thing that's about to go away. Let's hear it.
Well, you know, maybe in the next expansion. I'm Ashranning the future here.
Oh, okay. Gross. Don't do that too much. You'll go blind.
It's really, really similar to what Ashran was at the beginning that Jocelyn loves so much. And keep in mind, I'm totally channeling Blizzard here.
Okay.
Also I'm gross. Adding green fire everywhere, too.
Okay. Oh my God. Boom. You did it.
Okay.
Totally nailed it. That's what we're missing. Awesome.
Every time you kill a warlock, they explode into green fire.
And it's persistent forever.
Yes.
Soon all of Ashran will just be burning in green flame. We can't walk anywhere.
Like, guys, please stop killing the warlocks. My frames per second is down to 2.
But you are a warlock. Guess what? Now it's down to 1.
Really, the only thing that they did that really broke Ashran was not allowing the big groups, which I find kind of ridiculous because now people are just doing the same thing that they did for Alterac Valley, is basically you have to go to a website and find a password and then join event and then tell them the password and then they'll invite you to the 5-man group and then they all just 5-man group queue into the same Ashran instance. And they wait until everybody's queued in. And then once they get everyone in the same instance, they just roll it. So I'm just like, basically, they're still doing the same thing. Blizzard just made it a little bit harder. And I'm like, and now I have to be in vent with these people. They're 12 and they say terrible things. I don't want to hear that. Yeah. I'd rather just queue into a 40-man raid through the group finder and just do that, Blizzard. Like... Every single group, if you look in like the group finder for Ashran, it just says password required, vent required, password required. And I'm like, oh, this is not better.
Yeah, I totally understand what it's like when you run around with a whole bunch of people and they say horrible, horrible things like in Raid.
Oh, come on. Raid was awesome.
Is Ben getting picked on still in Raid?
Not enough. No. Well, by your standards anyway.
No. All right.
Ben was not picked on hardly at all. He had a very important role. We had to keep throwing some sort of gemmy thing at him.
Oh, wow. Yeah. I'm practiced for that fight.
Well, John, you will be happy to know that I still gave Civ a lot of crap.
Oh, good. Good. This is important. Yeah. It's important that Civ knows. The only game he gets to be good at is Duck Game. And even then, it's because he's just got no life and he's overpracticed and he's a horrible human being.
You overpractice in Duck Games?
Yes.
Wow.
He does weird things. Don't play Duck Game with Civ. That's my advice to the world.
Oh, man. One thing I actually am doing in Warcraft right now that I am absolutely loving, and I've never done it before, I'm leveling an alt with heirlooms.
Oh, holy, isn't it great?
It's so fast. I was like, I played for an hour, and I went from like level 3 to level 12, and I was like... What? It was great.
And you feel cool. You're like mostly dressed in awesome armor. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Except for your boots.
I know they should really just do boots at this point because it looks so dumb that you're just like all decked out in mail and you're like, yeah, I am awesome. And then you're barefoot. Like, it's like, here's your green booties of sundering. And it's just like,
plus one armor. And plus one vanilla styling.
I feel like a
gloves
hobbit.
With holes in the fingers, and it's just your armor is gleaming and look like a hobo in places.
In places.
I could only afford this much armor.
And then I really wasn't sure because basically I have I cap out on honor all of the time. Like I'm constantly throwing away thousands of honor points. Every time I check my Gladiator Sanctum, they're like, we have 2,000 new honor points. I'm like, well, that's going to go in the garbage. So I bought like all of the honor heirlooms. And then I made a paladin. She's Blood Elf Paladin. Cause,
hey.
Oh, I love Blood Elves. Well Don't
played.
Judge me.
Well played.
Mm-hmm. So, the Blood Elf Paladin lore story is actually really cool too, but that. Again, I'm not going to go into all that, but it's really cool.
It is.
So anyways, I made a Blood Elf Paladin, and I'm just like, there's a big sword. There's a little sword. There's a hammer and a shield. Like, I, how do I paladin? I don't know. So I just made them all. It's like, here you go.
That's what I did too, because I made a warrior alt recently, and I'm looking at my heirlooms, and I'm like, all right, I've got a curvy sword, and I've got a non-curvy sword, and I can only have one of this sword, but I can have as many as I want of this sword, and I'd like to dual wield. Oh, I can dual wield the two-handed sword as well. Oh, and I can also dual wield my two-handed axe. Okay, this is this is a dilemma of choices I've been presented with here.
And oh, I can, like, have a shield?
I have no idea on a paladin. Like, I know on Hunter, I want agility. On paladin, I have no sweet clue. So I'm just like, this looks like a hammer paladin thing. You have a spell called Hammer of Wrath. This must go together, right? Yeah.
Hammers with hammers.
Yeah, makes sense.
Yeah, fact. So I spent like 2 or 3 hours leveling her so far, and I'm just about to go into Ghostlands, and I'm just like, oh, this is so great. I'm just gonna like dungeon and pet battle my way to the top.
So are you planning on trying tanking with your paladin?
Really what I'm trying to do, because I have a priest, a druid, a shaman, and a paladin. And I'm pretty much just trying to figure out what fits me from like a healing standpoint, because eventually I do want to be a competitive healer, and I feel like paladin's probably the way to go. I know that generally in PvP, they wreck me. So I'm like, well, can't beat them, join them.
Let me tell you about the monk.
Yeah, that's why I played Nova too. Last night.
I have a monk. Actually, I totally even forgot that I have a monk, but I have, yeah, so I have a druid, a priest, and a monk, all somewhere in and around 92-ish.
They walk into a bar.
Exactly. They walk into the garrison, and then I leave them there to rot. my shaman is somewhere in and around, like, I want to say, like, 50, 60, basically right about to go into Burning Crusade, and then I drop them.
Yeah.
I understand that.
Correct.
Completely.
That is the right behavior before going to Outland.
Yeah. So, now I've started Paladin. And so now I've pretty much got one of all of the Healy things. I just have to figure out which one I want to use. And I think it's a Paladin. I'm having so much fun with the Paladin. And normally I don't like melee things. So I'm coming around.
Yeah. No, I really enjoy my Paladin, but I actually tank on her. And that's something that I didn't think I was going to really enjoy, but it's really, really satisfying when you do your, like, AoE hammer thing, and you hear this big clang. I'm like, oh, that's really cool. And
that
then
was my hammer.
Yeah,
I
exactly.
Did that.
And, you know, when you get your Avenger shield and, you know, your Captain America throwing a shield around and stuff, like, that's pretty cool, too. And
I do like randomly like just running through big groups of mobs and just like dropping hammers on their heads and just being like, and you're, especially with the heirlooms, just like, and you're dead, and you're dead, and you're dead, and you're dead. Quest, please.
Stop. Hammer time.
You get it.
You should play that. You should just bind that to where anytime you hit that key, that just plays. You'd get really
sick
of it.
So sick of it.
It's like, well, I finished one quest. That's being turned off.
Stop. Hammer. Stop. 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 Hammer. Stop. Hammer.
Stop.
Stop.
You stop.
Hammer. Stop. Hammer time. I'm the best paladin ever.
I totally thought you were going to say it again.
Yeah, he totally zigged when you thought he was going to sag.
That he did.
let me tell you about Johanna. No.
Wrong game, John.
I know, I know, I know. It's just you
are we trying to make it so that John doesn't talk about heroes?
Yeah,
I'm not supposed to talk about heroes on this show.
Tisk, but tisk.
I can't help it. He's talking about throwing shields and stunning people. It's fine. It's fine.
Yeah, that's right, Joss. You are the Oprah of paladins.
You get a hammer, and a hammer. You get a hammer.
Now, if you look under your seat, hammer!
Oh, no, sorry, that was consecration. Oh, my bad. Stay up from under your seats.
Sorry, I got it everywhere. Oh, geez, this doesn't come off, does it?
I want to see Ben get into tanking.
That'd be cool.
I already got into healing.
I know, and that's weird. Well, no, that's not weird, because I remember, okay, so when Ben was playing Final Fantasy, back when he was a confused, lost soul.
Final Fantasy 11.
He played a white mage. And so I was always like, when I tried to win him over to the WoW side, the, you know, bring him back to the light, I was like, Ben, you can play a priest. And like, that's the route I was going. I always thought he would just wind up as a healer, because he would always talk about, he would talk about healing in Final Fantasy the way people talk about like being the best DPS on a team. He'd be like, their health was low, I channeled a spell, got 26,000 healing crit right on him. It's just like, all right.
Well, see, that's where I know that you weren't listening, because I was healing on my summoner.
Well, whatever. You had a carbuncle
as my backup class, and I only had access to half the level of white mage spells that my summoner did, and that's why
all
I was so
awesome.
All of
this right now is like,
nerd.
Over my head. Summoners are like way different than white mages, so
exactly.
Don't even.
That's the,
don't even.
And that's the thing. No one wanted me in their party because summoners had horrible DPS, so I could only heal. But no one wanted a summoner to heal because they were bad, except for me.
You know what, Ben? When somebody says everybody's bad at a thing except me, that doesn't mean you were the only good one. It means you're in denial.
No, that means that people actually were like, holy crap, I didn't know that you could do that. Because everyone I've been with has been horrible. Where I was actually getting whispers from other people to heal
That's
for them.
She said.
I'm glad you called it out, because I was thinking it.
I'm done.
We're gonna put that quote in the show notes, Ben. Everyone I've been with has been bad. Episode 146, Azeroth Roundtable.
Thanks for that.
Anyway, we didn't have show notes.
This is the vigor with which he would talk about this game. And you're absolutely right. He would say it, and it would just go over my head. I'm like, I know what a carbuncle is. It's that weird, like, fox-looking thing that sounds like a barnacle. It's fine. And it does, like, ruby flash or something like that.
Well, the good news is that at least Ro knows what I'm talking about.
All right, go. You can go.
I know.
Talk
he started
Ro.
Talking about red mages last night, and I was just like, what? What?
I do like a good red mage. You see, they're
which
like.
Apparently, like.
White mages
know,
and black
for...
mages.
Huh.
But
you
watered
be
down.
A gray mage, but.
No.
No. Oh. No. Red.
Missed opportunity.
Yeah, that doesn't make. They get cool hats, though. That's the thing.
They do. They get a feather in the hat.
Yeah, you get a cool hat. Sign up to be a red mage, get a cool hat. I like red mages and dragoons.
Dragoons are pretty cool.
They jump. That's what their superpower is. In the Final Fantasy world, being able to jump is a superpower. They're like, what skills do you have? I can do this. And they're like, okay, dragoon. That guy's got some skills.
Well, he still hasn't come down yet, so when do we tell him he's a dragoon?
When he gets down. In a year. They're really good at jumping.
Yeah, so tanking, since we have two tanks on our raid team and potentially like a lot of people getting ready to be backup tanks next expansion, I don't know if it's something I really care too much about.
No?
I don't know.
Not into it? You don't want to be a tank?
If I'm going to tank, I kind of want to tank on my paladin just because, I don't know, I guess the internal story that I have for her of, you know, stand behind me. I've got this giant shield because I've got the bulwark of Azanoth. So, you know, the big one with the spikes on it.
Yeah.
And I may be weird for this, but I always transmog whatever weapon she's holding into the heirloom hammer that looks like Mjolnir. So I don't know. Tanking on her is just really cool. But then again, I've never done it on a monk before. And the idea of being a drunken boxer and breathing fire is kind of neat.
That is pretty cool. I did, when I first started my monk, I started her as a tank. So she's dual spec'd for tank and healing. Excuse me, tanking and healing. Mm-hmm. And just throwing the kegs. It's kind of fun. That's like one of the first things you learn how to do is throw a keg.
And you can spam it, which is, that's what sold me on it. I was like, all right, throwing a keg sounds pretty cool. And then I was like, oh shit, I can throw a lot of these out. I can just start. I'm like Donkey Kong. This is great. Yeah. Sorry, Ben, you lost me at the big one with spikes on it, and I didn't hear the rest, but I'm sure you have a good reason for tanking. It's fine.
Yeah. Okay. Thanks, John. You're welcome. Appreciate it. Glad that you're actively, you know, trying to talk to me.
Active listening, Ben. I listen until I hear something inappropriate, and then I'm out for a little while.
We just lose you.
Yeah.
So, Jocelyn, obviously you're going to, you know, definitely go back into whatever PvP is going on in Legion and everything like that. Yeah. I'm assuming that if you do decide that you enjoy raiding with us, that you're going to probably stick with the Hunter and do that on PvP as well, maybe?
I'm not actually really sure. So I know I'm going to PvP with my Hunter because I just love PvPing with her. She feels like such a badass because you're just like running around the edge of the group, just like pew, 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 run, 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 and stealth. So I don't know. Like, I love PvPing with the Hunter. And so I want to run her through, get her max level as fast as possible because I want to start proceeding with her as quickly as possible. And I don't really know what I'm going to do because I have, basically, we're going to do some sort of like a streamy group leveling type of a thing with everybody from A Move, so Garrett and Kyle and you know, the significant others and everybody. We're all just gonna kind of level together and do dungeons together and all that kind of fun stuff. So I don't want to do that with my Hunter because I want to push her as fast as possible.
Yeah.
So I need to have a tune that I do that with, and then I feel like I have to have a tune that I do raiding with. That's a lot of stuff to get to max level pretty quickly. So I don't really know what I'm going to do. If I'm going to do anything, it'll be PvP and raiding with the Hunter because she's my main and I feel like I should probably just do everything on her. But I also don't really know what it's like to have a serious raid team right from the start of an expansion. So I feel like there's probably a lot of stuff that I'm going to have to do for raid.
Well,
I don't know. Am I way off there?
You're not going to have a serious raid team right at the start of the expansion because it's probably going to take us a month or two before we actually get into it, just because we are more casual. So it's going to take us longer to level and get everybody set and stuff like that. At least that's if the last two expansions have kind of, well, the last one expansion, I guess, it really kind of, you know, show that. So, you know, we might get a little late start on that.
I just feel like everyone's always talking about, oh, well, have you crafted this? And do you have these mats? And have you done this, this, this? And I'm like, nope. Hasn't even done the dungeons for her legendary ring yet. Like, I don't PvE.
Understood.
So I feel like where I sink so many hours into PvP, it might be challenging anyway, and so it's probably a good idea if I don't have to worry about level, like doing the kind of 100 to 110 content. If I just have to, you know, she's already at 100. Just do the raid things with the tune that you're playing all the time is probably the best way to go about it instead of having three mains for different things, if that makes sense. So I don't know.
No, it totally makes sense. I mean, I'm going to do the stupid thing of leveling two people and depending on what we need for raid, taking that one.
Well, and that's the other reason that I've kind of gravitated to the first thing I made was, let's see, sorry, I did the priest, then the monk, then the druid, because, I mean, the priest, at least you could do damage or you could do healing. But then the druid and the monk, you can do whatever. Like, you can tank or you can heal or you can DPS. And I felt like being a little bit more versatile would be helpful to whatever raid team I ended up on. So I kind of gravitated towards the more versatile specs, and I think that might have been a mistake, even though I know I can heal and tank and DPS with a pally. Like, I don't know why it took me so long to try pally. I think it was just, like, I didn't want a melee. I wanted to just, like, stand back and do stuff. And that might have been a mistake. That really might have been a mistake.
Well, now that really you've makes admitted sense, that, let me tell you about the rogue.
I don't know about rogue. I do have a death knight. My death knight is around level 80. And I enjoyed her. I just got sick of leveling. But I should have pallied a long time ago.
Yeah, no, I was kind of the same way because, you know, started off on mage, did that for a very long time. And then it took me a while before I really got in and started doing melee and realizing, oh, this is very different. Things are actually punching me. I need to be a little bit more careful, as opposed to kill it before it gets to me. It's
yeah,
before I die now. Totally different. But
yeah,
I'm
not used to getting hit. I'm not used to taking damage. It took me a really long time in PvP, and even I still don't watch it nearly enough, but just watching my health total is a thing I never had to do. Like, I never had to learn in, like, when I was leveling, I never had to learn how to move, I never had to learn a rotation, I never had to learn to watch my health total, because it was basically just, like, either I was playing with a pet, and my pet was tanking, and so the thing never got to me, or, you know, I was playing with a friend and the thing never got to me. And basically, if I had, you know, my pet out, or if I had a friend, or, you know, whatever the case may be, very, very rarely was it just me. Like, now I'm running Lone Wolf spec, so it's just me. And my health total is actually, like, taking a hit every once in a while. And, like, adjusting to that and looking at that and being like, wow, I'm actually taking damage? Man, that's so hard.
Oh, yeah.
Don't know how people do it.
Yeah, like, especially in the middle of raid when there's so much stuff going on, and the healer's like, use cookies, please, because we're,
yeah,
we can't do this.
Well, that's the other thing, too. I'm like, cookies? Why? Like, oh, why do you need to use it? Like, I always get them from the soul well because someone gets excited about cookies, so I'm like, well, I guess I should have these. Like,
I don't know. They're way into the cookies. One. Seems rude not to take one or right. Three.
Exactly.
So what they do is they give you some health.
I did know that. Like, I know what the actual use is. It's like, whenever it gets dropped after a wipe, I'm like, oh, did you guys use those? Like, I was still standing in the back alive when you guys all died.
We could tell.
I was doing my job. I was DPSing.
I know. Hi, guys, I was back here. I saw you died. It sucks that you guys died.
Oh, but it's coming towards me. Feign death.
That's cool. I'm still alive. I didn't need the cookies.
Can I throw some cookies at you?
Anyone want to share?
I'm the best at raiding ever. I still have all my cookies.
That's how it works, right?
That makes
There's
me
a cookie
the
tally at the end of the night.
Yep.
All right, I got all my cookies. What do I cash them in for? I heard there were going to be fabulous prizes.
Yeah, you get to pay our repair bills.
Oh.
That doesn't make sense.
Oh, man. I was so confused last night too, because I didn't realize that there was like a new bonus roll token.
Oh.
So I have like so many tokens from, because I didn't do any raiding, it's just from like stuff in the garrison that's randomly like, have a token. I'm like, okay. And so everyone's like, oh, what'd you get on your bonus roll? I'm like, I didn't get an option.
Oh no. And you have all that extra honor that you can use this biome too.
Well, now I know that. But going into last night, I was like, oh, man, why can't I bonus roll? I have like 12 or 10 or something, some amount of bonus rolls. And then I was like, oh, because they added another currency because yeah. Blizzard.
Yeah.
Sorry, I tried to think of everything I could.
No, it's not your problem. It's Blizzard.
Here, have a cookie.
Have three.
I won't eat them.
We will count later to see how many cookies you've consumed.
None. I consumed none cookies. Oh, man. I love doing this show with you guys. Can I just say that? It's so much fun.
Well, I'm glad. I mean, I know I enjoy it. I can't speak for John, though.
I'm always having fun, and I like having Jocelyn here. So you're always welcome on the show. I mean, we Yay. Invite you enough. I'm sure enough of the listeners are like, why is Jocelyn always on the show?
Just give her own chair already. Come on.
Jeez. Put another window in the Murloc picture.
Oh, but yeah, that works. But with that, Jocelyn, how can people find you?
Best place to find me is over on Twitter. I am at Joss Plays. That's J-O-C-E Plays. It's the same as my Twitch channel. I stream pretty much all the time now because it's my job. So if you want to check it out, that is twitch.tv/JossPlays. that's pretty much it. Whenever I'm doing something, it's always tweeted out. So that's really the best way to keep up with it. But if you want to see my podcast and everything that all of my friends are doing, check out amove.tv. That is for the Angry Chicken, Into the Nexus, Gamers In, and the Angry Nerd, and Overwatchers. We have so many shows now, I keep forgetting.
Very cool. John, how about you? Where can people find you?
You can follow me on Twitter, John_Jagger. You can catch me on this show. You can catch me on Core!
Core!
Yep. See, I'm remembering. I gotta yell it, or else Ben gets mad at me. That's part of the Frog Pants Network. That is a Heroes of the Storm podcast, where I do not get in trouble for talking about Heroes of the Storm and Johanna and other amazing things. So that's where you can find more of that. You can also catch me on Experience Points. That's from 12 to 3 Mountain Standard Time. That's every Saturday. That's on twitch.tv/frogpants_Scott. I always have trouble because that underscore throws me off. But yeah, we play games. That's where Duck Game gets played a lot, among other things. And Duck Game is amazing, and that's my recommendation for right now as well.
All right. I would like to point out that the no talking about Heroes of the Storm was a self-imposed rule by you.
I know. I admit to
I just wanted to put that out there in case anyone's yelling at me because, like, Ben, let him talk!
You're supposed to rein him in, Ben! Yeah, it was me. I reined myself in. I realized that I just want to talk about Heroes a lot, and it's fine. It's a problem. It's not a problem. It's a solution. It's a
The solution is the other show.
Yes, the solution is the other show.
Exactly. If you're looking for me, you can find me on Twitter. I am at Ben the Mage. I do another show called Battle Pets and a third one called Geektopia, which will be coming back sometime soon. We're in talks of figuring that out.
In talks. I love it.
By in talks, I mean Steve basically said, Ben, we need to do this again soon. I said, yes, and we need to talk about Star Wars. And he said, yes. And I know that Kim has, I believe, is seeing it this weekend. So we should be getting together to do that soon.
Well, you were right about one thing, Ben. The negotiations were short.
Great. If you want to follow this show, we are on Twitter at, I almost said El the Mage. No, that's not there. At AzrothRT. If you have any questions, comments, want to yell at me for reining in John or his self-imposition of reining himself in, send those to AzrothRoundtable@gmail.com. And, of course, all of our episodes are on AzrothRoundtable.com as well as iTunes, Stitcher, and TuneIn. And last but not least, our intro contains music from Volatile Reaction by Kevin MacLeod. You can find more of his music at incompetech.com. So thanks for joining us, and have a great night, everybody.
You have that written down, don't you?
I don't, actually.
You looked like you were reading. I see a hand. I think it's waving at Jocelyn.
I saw part of a hand.
Yeah.
I miss you in your face.
Suddenly there was a hand.
Hi. Oh, and boobies. I saw boobies.
I saw boobies, too.
I miss you.
She has the little thing I gave her on her chair. Yay!
Chat room.
It's so
this is
cute when it jiggles when you move.
This is what happens when Jocelyn's on. There turns into a Sarah and Jocelyn moment.
I miss you so much.
I miss you too. We need to Heroes.
You'll hear it in a second.
I'm not listening.
Oh.
Ouch, my feelings.
She said you need to Heroes.
Yes. I like Heroes, so freaking message me so we can play.
You're never online when I'm online.
Yeah, you're never online when she's online.
Well,
she said,
you and your stupid
Ben, I don't
zone.
Think you need to translate the
laughing.
The whole the laughing. Yeah, I think that part is fine.
I don't know. I think you did a really good job, actually. I'm impressed.
Thank you. Take that, John.
What? It's fine. Wow, I could go my whole life without seeing that ever again.
Okay, I'll try to remember that. Joss, thank you so much. It's a blast having
Thanks for having me. That felt short. Was that like way shorter than it used to be?
Yeah, we're keeping him at about an hour or so now.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You totally threw me off because you were just like, and where can people find you? I was like, oh, we're done? Okay.
Well, normally.
I don't know, so I don't know. There's no Murloc Theater. There's no emails. There's no, okay, bye.
Oh, speaking of which, I keep forgetting. We need to do this every week. We have a Murloc Theater thing we need to do, Ben.
We do?
We have a commitment from last year that has yet to be fulfilled.
Yes.
And I don't want it to go too far before. So we'll do that next episode. How about that?
Okay. Or the week after when I can afford it.
Okay. We'll do that the week after when you can afford it.
Okay.
And that's probably when I can afford it as well. I don't know. When's
See, perfect.
Oh, no. I can afford it next week, but the week after will also work. So that's fine.
Wonderful.
Oh, Ben, I meant to tell you. I don't think I told you. I loved Star Wars. Star Wars was amazing. I was, for anybody watching and probably John who doesn't know, I'm actually not a Star Wars fan. I totally missed out on the whole, like, Star Wars experience. So, like, my first Star Wars in theaters, obviously, was the prequels. But, like, I literally watched 4, 5, and 6 right before I went to go see 1.
Good.
So, I had no, like, I guess, ties to it. It was kind of okay because pop culture already ruined everything for me. So when he's like, Luke, I am your father, I'm like, I already know that. Like, this is not new.
This is common knowledge, Darth. The people know.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So then when I actually went to go see The Force Awakens, we saw it twice in one day, and it was like the best day of my life. I was like, mm-hmm. Oh my God, I get it now. I understand the hype. I love Star Wars. Like, this movie was amazing. It was so good.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, I want to go see the movie.
I wanted to share that with you, that the Force Awakens brought me around to the loving of the Star Wars. BB-8's so cute. Yeah, I hearted him so hard.
John, if I didn't have to do battle pets tonight, I would try to scrape some cash together to go.
Gosh dang it, Ben. I was about to ask you too. I was like, man, I'm sure there's a showing we could go right now.
Yeah, we probably could. Let me just let me see.
Tell Aludra, like, oh man, Aludra, I forgot that I had to go to a movie that I've seen 4 times already.
5 times.
5 times already.
Hold on, let's.
Now I'm holding BB-8 because I'm thinking about it.
Because BB-8 reasons. All I have to hold is a Hearthstone.
That's just what he calls. Never mind.
No, it's hey.
Penis
I
joke.
Would not do that because BB-8 is sacred. Do not try to corrupt BB-8.
Oh man.
Well, here, let me help you with that because I have my BB-8 pop vinyl right here.
Got that from Matt for Christmas. It's sitting right in front of his monitor too.
Well, perfect. Okay, well, I'm waiting for an answer. Hopefully
42.
Chat room, you're all invited to go see Star Wars with us.
If we go.
You're still invited. I mean, you can do whatever you want. We're not your parents.
That is true. We're not your parents. If that happens, I'm the dad.
Okay.
Yep.
Why did you feel the need to claim that?
I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about.
Are you so, like, old school in your beliefs that you think it has to be, like, one dad?
Mom. Yeah.
Like.
No, basically it just means that I don't have to pay attention to the... I don't know.
Our definition of family has changed, Ben. This is the year 2016. There could be 2 dads, and it's fine.
Yeah, I know.
Why don't you... I don't know, some old-fashioned train of thought thing. Why don't you go Ashran yourself?
Oh, but John, I don't know if I could.
Oh, man.
Haven't gotten an answer back, so there is a chance, John.
She's asleep. We can go see Star Wars. Shh, we'll go. Just go. Don't tell anybody.
All right, guys. Well, I do have to go. I have to get back to my date night.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
No, it's totally fine. I was like, Matt's like, so what are you doing tomorrow? I'm like, nothing. He's like, do you want to like have date night? I was like, yeah, I do. And then I'm like, totally forgot that I do that. So we were literally driving to dinner. And I was like, honey, I have a podcast in like 2.5 hours. Is that okay?
It'll be like a date night, sort of.
They're just going to be 2 random guys for a little bit. Don't go, though. It's okay.
All right. Well, so you get to your date night. That's important.
It is very important.
Although you should still totally, you should totally say, hey, why don't for date night we go see Star Wars?
Yeah.
Well, it's 11 o'clock now, so I don't think that's that okay. Anyone
we
is
have
showing
until
here.
Like midnight, probably.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, maybe. I don't know.
It's like a Denny's. Star Wars is like Denny's. Anytime is fine.
I'll keep that in mind. All right, guys. I'll talk to you later. Thanks for having me
Thank
again.
You.
Bye.
You're awesome.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, still haven't gotten an answer back. But we weren't supposed to get together till 10, so.
All right, look, if Jocelyn can forget a show and run out on date night, then we're totally fine to forget a show and not have date night. Let's be careful with our phrasing, but go see Star Wars.
No, I can't just up and do that, but I am checking on times.
Yes, yes, do it. Do it. Do it. Good. Good. Give in to your desire to watch Star Wars, and your journey to the dark side will be complete.
Yeah, that I'm fine with that. Okay. Well, at Desert Ridge and non-3D, there's a 1045.
Totally good with that.
So I will know by 10 if we're doing the movie, or doing the movie, if we're doing the show or not.
So wait, what time is it at Desert Ridge?
1045.
1045? All right, cool. Well, I'll just make sure that I'm ready then.
Just in case. It'll be regular if we do it.
And yes, Wicked, if you can get here in time, that would be great.
Would you like to join us?
No, you can have a bro date.
I can have a bro date.
Bro date?
She said bro date. Like what?
It's like prostate.
No, it's not like
Let's
prostate.
Let's not compare it to that. That goes, that
You're
goes
weird.
To a dark place. Literally goes to dark place.
Yeah. Let's see. Well, let me
see. I'm glad I thought of getting out of the Slack conversation, because sure enough, I got a ton of messages, so hold on.
Oh, well, that's good. Okay, well, here's the thing. I'm going to go ahead and go and have a nice little break from podcasting in case I'm going to be doing another one tonight. And I will let you know right around 10 to 10:15 on if we're going to go see Star Wars or not.
Perfect. Sounds good. I will be ready.
All right. And let me see if it's one of those where you have to actually, like, choose your seats.
Choose your seats. You have chosen poorly. You will now be in the front row.
Yeah, we'll have to choose our seats, but there's Well, hold on. There's only been two that have been bought so far, so I think we'll be fine.
Okay. Well, do you want to just do it online or just do it when we get there?
Well,
how does it work?
Once I find out if we're actually doing it.
Oh, good point.
We can do it online.
We'd be kind of committed at that point.
Yeah, pretty much.
I see what you're saying. Gotcha.
See what I'm saying?
Hey, see what I'm saying? You know what I mean?
See what I'm saying?
Gotcha. Gotcha.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
All right, cool. Well, let me know.
All right. You bet.
It's a good thing this all got included in the show.
Yep. I'm going to go ahead and end the Alpha Geek stream.
This is important information.
Bye, Alpha Geekers.
That they needed to know. That was that we might go see The Force Awakens tonight.
It is important.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm pleased that people liked our Star Wars episode.
I'm really happy that they did. A lot of people actually really liked it.
I was worried about it because I was like, all right, we did an episode that was as long as the movie, about the movie.
Yeah, longer, actually, right? A little bit.
Longer than the movie. But people seemed to like it. That was a fun one to edit. I didn't get to do all the things I wanted to do, but I got to do some of them, and I was happy.
I haven't had a chance to actually listen to a lot of it yet, but I heard the beginning with the R2 beeps and stuff, and I'm like, hey,
yeah,
Good job.
The only thing you need to know is that anytime anybody swore, it just goes Ichuta.
How rude.
That's it. That's, I mean, that's basically it. Oh, and at the very end, Darth Vader goes, no. That's basically it. That's all you need.
Okay, that's pretty fantastic, actually. I might need to listen to that whole thing now.
All right, well, do what you got to do, and I'll talk to you in a little bit.
All right.
Bye, Internet.
Bye, Internet.
We'll miss you. Stay classy.
Yes.